Police are searching for a man who abducted a three-year-old on the New South Wales north coast. The little girl was reunited with her parents after a frantic 90-minute search after their family car was stolen with her inside. She was left at a nearby holiday apartment.
I was really, really frightened. We were frightened that anything could happen to that little girl. So I just hope they get him.
Her six-year-old sister was also inside the car but managed to escape. Police say they're searching for a man of Aboriginal appearance. A second person has died from a deadly batch of homemade spirits in Queensland. A group of friends were drinking homemade grappa on Saturday night. 21-year-old Joel Lynham and 30-year-old Brian Wilmot have since died. Two others are fighting for life in hospital.
And it's just a tragedy. So preventable, that's the part that upsets me the most. It's a wine-growing district and they should have more sense, you know.
Police say it's a serious warning about the dangers of homemade brews. A neighbour is being hailed a hero for saving twin boys from a house fire in Melbourne. The 18-month-old toddlers were asleep when the blaze broke out at the back of the house. Neighbour Abdullah Almania spotted the flames, woke the boys' parents and ran inside.
It was smoke there. So we tried to get the kids outside before the smoke ran all over the home.
It's believed the fire was sparked by an oven left on overnight. A speeding driver is on the run after a crash which killed a Sydney grandfather. The 70-year-old was struck after a car lost control, flipped and landed on a front lawn at Ambervale.
He's a really nice bloke. He's a good local around the area and everybody knows him.
The driver and his passenger fled the scene. Witnesses say the car was travelling at 100 kilometres an hour. Former Labor leader Mark Latham has launched an extraordinary attack on Kevin Rudd. It comes after Julia Gillard made it very clear she has no intention of standing down for the former Prime Minister. The speculation follows continued bad polling and reports she's lost significant support in caucus.
This is a program, a jihad of revenge, the like of which we've never seen before in the history of Australian politics. And it goes beyond the normal human reaction of revenge. You're getting into the realm of evil here with Rudd, the realm of evil.
It's understood Bill Shorten is being pressured to tap Ms Gillard on the shoulder. Authorities are being criticised for not acting sooner in the latest asylum seeker tragedy. Up to 60 people are now feared dead after their boat capsized off Christmas Island.
This is a terrible tragedy, underlining again the real dangers of embarking on these perilous journeys.
Refugee groups say authorities should have acted as soon as the vessel was spotted in trouble last Wednesday. And video has emerged of a Melbourne train commuter taking the law into his own hands by confronting a brazen vandal armed only with a camera.
Guess what, matey? You're gone. Guess where this is going, boys? Straight to crime, stop us.
The passenger then took chase and tried to arrest him. Although this footage can be used as evidence, police say he put his own life at risk. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 23 degrees in Townsville, 17 degrees in Brisbane, 14 in Sydney, 13 degrees in Melbourne and Adelaide, and 11 degrees in Perth.